Hi, I'm Justin Chu, Product Manager of the Places API. Today I'm going to talk about how you can use the Places API to build location-based applications. Location-based applications are becoming all the rage, and for good reason. With mobile devices, apps are always at hand and can provide incredible value based on the end user's location and context. There's a number of Google services out there to help you integrate location into your app, including Google's geofencing and geocoding APIs. Most of those APIs, however, are typically based on user coordinates. Where the Places API excels is that it partners user location with accurate, comprehensive local data, so that your app isn't limited to working just with coordinates, but instead, real places. Places, like the Sydney Opera House, can help your app provide more viable use cases than just using geographic coordinates. Sharing a place to meet, attaching location to a status update, adding events to a place, or even creating a list of must-see attractions all become much easier when you work with real-world places. So with that, let's take a closer look at the Places API. The Places API is part of the larger Google Maps API product family, and you can use the API through either a JavaScript library or a standalone HTTP web service. The library is available via the Maps JavaScript API v3. The Places API is a rich local search API that includes several powerful location-based features that can connect your end users to places they care about. One of the biggest features of the Places API is our data quality. The Google Places API is powered by the same local listings database that powers Google Maps, which includes over 100 million listings all around the globe. These places are all vetted and moderated by numerous teams in order to become a real Google place, so developers can rest easy that their apps are using the most up-to-date, comprehensive, and accurate model of the world. Now, moving from the data side of things to more of the smarts, how many times have you groaned when faced with an address form on a mobile app? Don't your thumbs deserve something better than typing in a full address on a small keyboard? As both a user and a developer, you know that while typing in a location or address is hard work, it's often a vital part of a user flow. Otherwise, how can an app send a taxi to the right pickup location, know what area a user wants to rent an apartment in, or ship the product to the right address? To help your app get the data it needs and limit the pain for your end users, the Places API offers an autocomplete service, which provides type-ahead search functionality that both Airbnb and Sunrise Calendar already use today. The autocomplete API allows you to choose what types of places you want to get back. So, if you're a real estate app that only cares about cities, or a travel planning app that only cares about establishments, or let's say a geotagging app that cares about both, autocomplete can be customized to suit your needs. If you can't tell already, we're huge fans of autocomplete, and with its clear benefits to both developers like you and your end users, we believe it's a no-brainer integration for any location-based application. In addition to autocomplete, another one of the Places API's primary features is search. The Places API has two main flavors of search, nearby search and text search. Nearby search allows you to define a particular radius to discover and explore establishments close by. Text search returns information about a set of places based on a query string. It's like having the magic of Google Maps search box inside your own application. Both endpoints also include various knobs and levers so that you can customize what type of data is returned. For example, in this map, we're only showing museums around central Sydney. Showing specific types of places is only one of the many customizations you can do. You can also choose to return to your end users only places that are open now, or ones at a specific price level. With the Places API search features, you can enable your users to find, explore, and share places that matter to them. Finding a place was often just the first step. Users might want more information about a place beyond just its name, location, and type. For example, if you're building a travel planning tool which suggests restaurants, shops, and sites and hotels, your users will likely need access to phone numbers, price levels, and hours of operation to complete their reservations. They'd also likely need photos and reviews to help with picking the best places to stay, visit, and eat. This valuable place information, along with a handful of other useful data fields, is all available with the Places API detail service. To get a Places details, all you need is its identifier, which is returned from both the search and autocomplete services. Now, while we're extremely confident about Google's local listing data freshness, we also know that the world's places change very, very quickly. And sometimes your end users may know more about new places before we do. The Places API allows you to add new places so that your users can interact with them immediately. Perhaps your app encourages users to share exciting places with friends. What happens if someone discovers a shiny new Google shoe store and can't find it with the API? You can use the Add a Place action to add the place to the app so that your users can always interact with their model of the world in addition to Google's. This is a very quick overview of the Places API. There's so much more you can do. Please click this link to get to our documentation. We also have a thriving community of developers on Stack Overflow where you can ask technical questions and find tons of advice and insight about how to best use the Places API. Thanks so much for checking out this video. I look forward to seeing what you can do with the Google Places API.